Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seat for a few more minutes where we can distribute the awards for the Youth Leadership Program.
I must ask you to believe me when I say that I have never made a statement of this description that the masses.
I have a dream that one day, and fellow South Africans, I greet you all.
نحن كنا مثلكم باب الاتحاد كنا هكذا
Where there is righteousness in the heart, where there is righteousness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. When there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, when there is an order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there is peace in the home.
Today, it is an honor for me to be speaking again after a long time.
We want a safe future. We want real climate action and we want climate justice. Did you hear me? What do we want?
Climate justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Climate justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
The leaders must.
Leaders and leaderships. Leadership is the capacity to translate vision into reality. If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader. Leaders are there everywhere and all the time. Some are popular, some are not. Some leaders define and inspire their time. Some others define and inspire their time and time to come. Leaders are not born. They are made. They are made just like anything else. Through hard work, leadership and communication skills. Tikim Toastmasters Club, part of Toastmasters International, the world's largest non-profit educational institution specialized in leadership and communication skill development, joined hands with TKMC Alumni UAE Chapter to conduct Youth Leadership Program 2021 in last summer. The program was designed to develop the speaking and leadership skills of young participants to meet the demands and challenges of today's world.
Thank you for joining us today. We have a crisp agenda for today's inaugural program that would, of course, lead on to the first session.
I officially inaugurate this Youth Leadership Program as President of TKM Alumni, and I congratulate.
The first step is the most difficult part. People are reluctant to take that step. Now, all of you have taken, as participants and parents, you have taken that first step. Indeed, it's a bold step.
And what I can tell the children is you are at the right place, because the skill you are learning from here is useful in your future life.
I can assure you and the participants, if you actively participate in these programs and continue the journey, you will definitely eliminate one of the basic phobias.
It's indeed a very great initiative, and I'm happy to be associated with this inaugural function.
Magic is believing in yourself. If you can make that happen, you can make anything happen.
The valedictory function or session of the 2021 Youth Leadership Forum that has and is culminating, I am sure, a tremendous learning journey.
But if you want them to be men and women of substances in the future, you need to nurture them now.
At the outset, let me congratulate the 25 youth leaders who has inspired to join this program.
You assess the right mood when that matter is to be touched, and then how to persuade your parents.
And I must congratulate you and wish you all the best in this journey, because this journey has nothing but only success and a better personality creation than anything.
Congratulations to all Toastmasters members and participants.
So please share this knowledge on your path, which helps others to enrich their life.
Now your action, your speech, your words should inspire others.
Though we had an unconventional year, we can proudly say we have all made it to success.
You have excellent inborn capabilities. You are lucky enough.
Yes. Leaders have to be effective communicators.
All the parents who might have spent 8 to 10.
Welcome you all for the valedictory contest session of YLP 2021. Warmly invite Toastmaster Jayasudha ma'am, who is the contest chair for the speech.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nesma, for that lovely introduction.
Sometimes I have also tasted failures and difficulties.
I'm a 15-year-old from India. My family consists of my parents, my younger 6-year-old sister, and I guess you can...
I am ambitious, determined, and
inspired to become an astronaut. Initially, my dream was to be a soldier, but I changed my mind a few
hours after I want to do something. What exactly do I want to do?
I usually spend my time making edits or watching TikToks. I guess.
I often used to wonder why the most important shapes.
If college education is needed, then they can save a lot of money.
Contestant number 8, Pranav Rajesh. Speech title, Waiter from Hell.
Today, you feel like a laboratory rat. There is a struggle through a maze. Each time it wants a chunk of cheese.
We would love for our parents, but it's in the inside who matters, and all those random quotes that we get every morning in our class to be ourselves.
Why do we even have zoos? To entertain ourselves, go get ice cream, to learn about animals.
No virtual backgrounds, no chats, no filters, and no frequent asking. Am I audible and visible?
So our contest chair for the table topic session is Toastmaster Shanma. Toastmaster.
Contestant number 1, Lena Fatima. Comfort zone is a beautiful place, but nothing grows there.
You don't have to care what others think, and you're always safe there.
Comfort zone is where we are in our own element, where no one
can. Your comfort zone makes you happy and not intense.
A few things that I liked were that you didn't have any pauses, you were very articulate with your speech.
Perfection is not attainable, but if we chase perfection, we can catch excellence.
We're having a debate contest now, and the contest chair for the debate session is this.
Our youngsters debate on the topic, generation gap among teens and their parents, complimenting or conflicting.
And trying to make it work is like lighting a match underwater.
A generation gap prevents young people from attaining very valuable lessons from their adults.
This forms a major chunk in the so-called gap.
We are contrarily inclined to believe that this
jump... by saying that there are a lot of disadvantages among the gap among teens and their parents.
But on a particular subject, they are very different.
Each generation are of different ages and different eras and circumstances.
We can also fix the communication issue.
Great idea. So, I really enjoyed being the chief judge of this contest, and the level of the contest was really very good.
Of the prepared speech contest. And the winner is Farzan.
And the winner for the table topic contest today is Adeem.
And the winner is again backed by Muhammad Adeem.
Oh.
That's what really happened with about 25 young boys and girls during the summer of 2021 in 8 sessions. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the award ceremony of the Luth Leadership Program 2021. What you saw there was a glimpse of the proceedings of the Youth Leadership Forum. The participants had a lot of opportunities to prepare and present speeches, had speech evaluations, do impromptu speaking, handle group discussions, and participate in debates during these sessions. Now it's the time to recognize these bold decisions taken by the young leaders to conquer their fear of public speaking. And in that, I would like to invite the backbone of the Youth Leadership Program, the main coordinator, Mr. Rahim Ariyam, and coordinator Shanim, as well as, if I may request, our respected principal, Dr. Shaul Ameed, to also join us on stage to kind of distribute the awards.
YLP participants list. All participants are requested to come forward. Asin Anish, daughter of Anish Kasim, 1997, mechanical. Alia Nujum Nawaz, daughter of Nujum Nawaz, 1995, mechanical. Imad Firoz, son of Firoz Abdul Rahman, 2001, electrical and electronics. Imad Firoz. Fardeen Khalid Arafat. Son of Khalid Arafat, 1998, electrical and electronics. Govind Srihari. Son of Srihari Somasundaram, 1996, electrical and communication. Hamdan Abdul Rahim. Son of Rahim Abdul Rahman, 1991, mechanical. Hanan Abdul Rahim. Daughter of Rahim Abdul Rahman, 1991, mechanical. Mark Binsu. Son of Binsi Joy, 1995, mechanical. Mayuka Saibi. Daughter of Saibi Dev, 1999, architect. Muhammad Adeem. Muhammad Adeem, son of Anish Kasim, 1997, mechanical. Rehan Riyadh. Son of Riyadh Abdul Salam, 1998, civil engineering. Saliha Sawat. Daughter of Sawat Salihuddin, 1996, production engineering. Sarah Safir. Daughter of Safir Kesh, 2001, mechanical. Salman Riyadh. Son of Riyadh Abdul Salam, 1998, civil. Serena Siddiq. Serena Siddiq, daughter of Muhammad Siddiq, 1994, electrical and electronics. Shreya Binu, sister of Sharon Binu, 2016, mechanical.
Please give these participants and of the youth leadership a big round of applause. This was a great effort from them during the summer. We have a few more awards. These awards are from the competition winners. I'm going to name them in a particular order related to the contest. So in the decade competition, the second runner-up is Ryan Asif. Ryan Asif is the son of Ashid Rashid of 1996 Civil. The first runner-up in the debate competition is Alia Nujum Nawaz, daughter of Nujum Nawaz, 1995 Mechanical. The next topic is the table topic speech competition. The second runner-up, Lana Fatipa Liju, daughter of Liju Muhammad, 2000 Mechanical. Lana Fatima Liju, the table topic speech competition, second runner-up. And the first runner-up of the table topic speech competition is Pranav Rajesh, son of Rajesh Krishnan, 1994 Civil. The speech competition, second runner-up, Alia Nujum Nawaz again, daughter of Nujum Nawaz, 1995 Middle East, Mechanical. The first runner-up, Pranav Rajesh Krishnan. He's not here, okay. Then we'll move on to the next, the winner of that competition is Fardeen Khalid Arafat, winner of the speech competition. You've got a lot of awards this evening, Fardeen. You can't even handle that. So since you're here as the winner of the speech competition, I just wanted to, for you to share with this audience here, what did you think benefited you from the youth leadership program? And what was your experience? A quick minute.
Thank you. Today, I feel really happy for being a part of YLP. It had a drastic change on me, and it helped me enhance my speaking skills a lot. It made me believe that I will be able to influence my audience, and it also made me a confident speaker. So I would like to thank everyone who put their hard work and time into making this program successful. Thank you.
That's very great and mature words. Congratulations. Again, the last contest was the debate competition. The best debater was Muhammad Nadeem. Adim, is he here? Oh, yes, he is. That's again multiple awards for Muhammad Adim. Muhammad, a quick word from you.
Thank you. First of all, I want to thank everybody behind this award and the entire organizing team, including my fellow Toastmasters. YLP helped me achieve my dream. Why? Because of YLP, I hold a very prestigious position in my school. It's the position of the head boy, because YLP has showed me the way around impromptu debate, speeches, interviews, and speaking on the spot. And I'll forever be grateful to everyone who taught me in that session. Thank you, and I look forward to attending the next session.
Excellent words. That brings us to the end of the award ceremonies, but before we leave, we've got to make sure that... We want to make sure that we appreciate the efforts of some selfless TKMC alumni here who spent their time developing this program, time developing and shaping these kids for the future. Can I ask for a memento to be extended to the main coordinator and coordinators of the YLP program, Mr. Rahime Rahim Shanima? Please come to the come forward so that we can have Dr. Shahul Ahmed present you with some mementos. Shanima Khalid, wife of Khalid Arafat, 1998, Electrical and Electronics. And also Mr. Rahim Ereoman, who's the main coordinator, 1991 Mechanical. We want to appreciate the selfless work and efforts that these two have put into the whole YLP program. With that, thank you, Rahim and Shanmia, for your inspiring leadership. I'm going to hand over this to you to close the event with a few words.
I'd like to know from our guest, Dr. Shahul Hamid, sir, to just few words.
See, it is. I've seen this marvelous experience. It's a fantastic experience that our kids are coming up with great qualities of public speaking. Earlier, years back, I have the Bernard Shaw once write, there is an article, How I Became a Public Speaker. See, the way he molded himself as a public speaker, he has well narrated in that article, in that prose. So I do remember those Bernard Shaw's article while standing over in this dais, in this prestigious dais. So I congratulate all my children for winning this, for their efforts, for their achievements, and may Almighty God grace you with greater heights. Thank you. Thank you.
Dear parents and dear participants, let me share my experience in few words. These kids are amazing. I had an opportunity to interact with the generation next. There is a spark in each one of them. A spark can become a flame. A flame can become a fire. A fire can become an inferno, provided you nurture them at the right time, in the right way. I encourage all of you as parents to nurture these young leaders, and not only these young kids, those who are sitting on the dais. Unfortunately, very few kids are listening now. Nurture. With that, we end this award ceremony. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. Thank you, Dr. Shahul Hamid, sir. This we will now break for dinner. We know we've held you up from dinner, so please feel free to make your way to the foyer to have dinner. We have some exciting events, in fact, showcase events that come up after this, so please make your way back after dinner to witness some of the most fashionable choreographed events that are yet on display. Thank you.